Hello and welcome everyone here to back to Denver here for the road course version of this race, as it's the DC Solar National driver's turn to take on this, kind of roval, you can say, the Denver Oval, really. On your pole is going to be the 61 of Mitchell Collins, who won last week at the Brickyard, and he's going to be trying to get two in a row here. Andy Fell is going to start next to him. Then you have Greg Lee in the 60, followed by Bubba Jones. Jones, I believe, won this race last time we were here, or won the oval version of this race. And we have Christian Russell and Carson Hill, then Audrey Baranoskis and Desmond Allen in the 40 and the 11. And you have Cameron Hathaway and Dylan Young running out your top 10. Is there some of your starting lineups from 11th on back? So coming into this race, a very critical race. Can't stress that enough. 11 of 12 spots are taken in a playoff. So only one more driver who has yet to win the season can try to win here and get themselves into the playoffs. And as of now, only, five drivers are locked into the playoffs right now. But here's the commands here at Denver. And the drivers are now getting set to roll off the grid. So the drivers who are completely safe and will make it into the playoffs no matter what are Mitchell Collins, Dylan Young, Bubba Jones, Andy Fell, and I believe Sebastian Kuechly. Those are the only drivers who, no matter what, will be in a playoff. For those with only one win, they can still get eliminated if other drivers get multiple wins. So they're not really entirely safe. Mitchell Collins, he starts on the pole. He already has 3 wins this season, looking to make it 4. Andy Fell, he already won twice this season. He's looking to make it 3. So here we go, drivers getting ready here as they go through the guesses. The fans are already on their feet here at Denver's. Mitchell Collins, can he get 2 in a row here? As he's going to lead a field of green flag. And RA3 wide for second. Christian Russell way down, nearly in the blue right there. He's being really aggressive, wasting no time, as Mitchell Collins is going to slide up just a bit in the car, nearly up and over. And multiple drivers spinning around in the back, and Jones gets taken out as well. And a huge wreck in the back. Konstantinovich and others were collected. Oh, and Mitchell Collins sliding off of the course right there. He's going to lose a ton of position right here. There were 3-4 wide, and someone slipped up into someone else and collected Desmond Allen, Cameron Hathaway, Dylan Young. Konstantinovich nearly got through it, but right there gets clipped with the 38 as well and hard into the tire barriers. Carson Hill as well in the 12. He was taken out too. Can see right here. So I believe it's really hard to tell, but I believe Konstantinovich and Young may have made a bit of contact. See Cameron Hathaway go around as well. Carson Hill, he would have made it through, but then Ford just got turned down into him right there, and everyone just ran off the track. They'll still be able to keep going, I think. Let's see right here. Cameron Hathaway slipped up. Oh, okay, so it was definitely Konstantinovich, and I believe that's the 23 of Sebastian Kuechly. They made a little bit of contact, and it was just a chain reaction right there. Baranoskis nearly got clipped in the end right there as well. Hard hit into the barrier by Konstantinovich and the 38, but battle up here for the race lead. Christian Russell now takes the lead, and these guys are on pit road for some reason. Okay, weird. A lot of drivers battling side by side here in the back. Sylvester Sterling trying to get around the 35 of Quattro. There's the 11, Desmond Allen. He's still going, but with a heavily damaged race car. You also see Collins back there as well, but out front, Christian Russell in the 0. He's trying to run away with the race lead. Greg Lee currently running in the second position right behind him. There's been a line. Christian Russell, he's going to go off the course just a little bit right there. And that's going to allow Greg Lee to gain big on the 0. Greg Lee already has a win. He's trying to get another win to lock himself into the playoffs here. Should go through the field once again. A lot of drivers single file. Got some double file in the back. But Greg Lee now pouncing at the rear end of Christian Russell. He's going to go through the S's here. Ooh, Russell sideways. Believe Greg Lee just bumped him just barely. Oh, and a contact between the 01 John Wesley Allen goes around. Brett Parvin as well. Not too much damage on both drivers, but they're going to be in the back as Greg Lee was able to get around Christian Russell. But however, Christian Russell going to try and fight back to get that position, as Russell would love to get a win right now. It's been so long since we've seen Russell, Christian Russell in victory lane here in NORLA League. And here he comes now down to the inside of the 60. Get a really good five out of the field here. Make sure no one getting in trouble coming out of that corner. And Christian Russell is going to again in the clear Greg Lee. Russell being really aggressive. He knows it's crunch time as the playoffs will be coming up pretty shortly here. Baranoskis in third. She too has yet to win a race. Side by side right here, Bafod Sako and Andy Fell. You also have the 23 of Sebastian Kuklon battling with those guys as they go through the downhill S's here. Let's ride on board. Or not right on board. Let's see if we can get a really good flyby here of the big S's. I call them the big S's. We're going to see here pretty soon. Russell right now kind of about a half a second lead, maybe a bit more, as they go through the S's. No one really side by side in the top 10. Desmond Allen trying to get around Danielle right there. Also have Alex McCleary behind them. These guys are stuck on pit road for some reason. I don't know what that reason is. And holy cow, Christian Russell is completely checked out. Baranoskis is going to get second from Greg Lee in the 60. That corner right there is a very tricky corner. You can't make any mistakes or else your car will go sliding. Baranoskis didn't look like she exited that corner too good, as Greg Lee to the outside of her. She also has Bafod Sako is now going to try to make it three wide as he goes down to the inside of the 44 second. Bafod Sako, who's only win this season, came at Phoenix. He's in the playoffs, but not locked in as we ride on board. Outside.
Still out there.
So those guys are stuck on pit road for some reason. Oh, sideways right there. Michael Creed was able to save it. But Christian Russell right now running away with the race lead. Get a good view of these drivers going through the downhill S's. Most everyone in the top 10 is single file. So after this race, we had two Watkins Glen for another road course. Then after Watkins Glen, there'll be four races till the playoffs. And Christian Russell again overshooting the corner, but Bafod Sako did as well. So I don't think it's going to hurt the zero too much. However, here comes Baranoskis trying to get up to the back bumper of the two right there.
Baranoskis knows how important it is to try and get a win. She has still yet to win the season. Remember, early on in the season, she was injured out of Daytona and missed a couple races. And a little bit of contact right there with the two, Bafod Sako. Baranoskis is being really aggressive right now as they battle side by side for second.
Most everyone single file here. With three laps to go now, Nathan Fisher, he's trying to make it three wide as he's trying to go underneath Cody Goforth and Mitchell Collins. Nathan Fisher, one of the guys that everyone is surprised that does not have a win either this season. He dominated in the lower series, but doesn't have a win in the truck or here in the Nationals. She just made a pass on both drivers right there. About the 19 of Austin James, he's running really well right now.
They're out there. Nice and patient. Got him clear. Outside. Clear.
These drivers right here are just kind of stacked up. But as we head back up front, it's the zero of Christian Russell. We're going to take a quick break here at Denver, and we'll be back to take you to the finish as Christian Russell and the zero is out front.
Welcome back here, ladies and gentlemen, to Denver. As out front, it's still Christian Russell with the race lead. He's a second and a half over Bafode Sakho, who just ran it really wide right there. And Sakho gets into the grass just a little bit. It's going to allow for Baranoskis in the 40 to catch that two and maybe try to run side by side, get a bit of draft. Dude, those two have been battling for a couple laps now. And while they've been doing that, Christian Russell has been getting away. There's Dylan Young and others who are just now getting out of pit road, but a little bit too late for that. Not sure why they were kept on pit road so long. But at the line, it'll be... Oh, we got a car around. It's Gary Barlow in the zero. And he's going to collect Cody Goforth and Mills. Oh, man. Tough break for Barlow and Cody Goforth. Both were running... Well, inside the top 10, I'm going to see right here. I don't know if maybe Nathan Fisher came down a little bit, got into Barlow, but it's really hard to tell from that view. And then right there, Cody Goforth just gets into the double zero and ruined his chances of a top 10 right here. It looks like Barlow got sideways. He was trying to come back up on the track, and Nathan Fisher was there. And Fisher also kind of misjudged it, and... Bad luck continues for Nathan Fisher. Both him and Barlow does not have a win this season. Baranoskis is currently settled in the third position. Greg Lee running fourth. Sebastian Kuechelin running fifth. And you have Andy Fell right behind him. Fell, it's been a while since he's been a victory lane here in the National Division. He's looking for his third straight championship. Never been done in a NORLA league. So he's trying to get these... Wins to his name and trying to make it all the way to the final four. But here we go. The white flag is out for Christian Russell. Remember, if we get a new winner, the playoff field will be set. Unless we get, I forgot who won the last round. Who was the last driver to win? I can't really remember. But the last driver before Christian Russell to get their first win on the season. If Russell can win two races, then that driver will be eliminated. But Chris Russell just has to go a whole lap mistake-free here. As I mentioned before, it's been so long since we've seen Christian Russell in victory lane. Most of the top five, top 10 are all single-file drivers. And the last driver to get a win was Brett Pavritt. So if Christian Russell wins this race, and if he wins another race, then Brett Pavritt will be eliminated from getting into the playoffs. So... That's how the points going to work this year right now. Christian Russell looking really good to do so. Just got to not make any mistakes at all. Before Sakho trying to hunt him down. Sakho isn't safe either, but he's more safe than Pavritt is at least. Russell, he didn't overshoot the corner that time. And now on to the backstretch. Before Sakho definitely gained a little from the last lap. Went from a second and a half to 1.3 seconds. But Christian Russell, can't say this enough. He has been having such bad luck this season. Then mid-season, he just started to really start to run with these drivers. And he's finally going to do it. You can hear the crowd on their feet. Christian Russell, welcome back to victory lane as he's going to win it at Denver and make the playoffs. Christian Russell is going to go back to victory lane here in NORLA.
Good work, everybody. Way to clean that thing up, guys.
And it's going
to
come here at Denver. The last time Christian Russell won anything in the NORLA League was at the Paris Circuit over in the ARCA series. And since then, things have just not been the same. Ever since that Atlanta crash, if you remember, was a really bad crash. For Russell at Atlanta, and then after that race, it just not has been the same for Christian Russell. But with the win today, he is now the 12th seed into playoffs. But remember, he is not safe until he gets two or more wins, or you know, if he can hold that spot until the playoffs come. Before Sakho, Audrey Baranoskis, and others, I've already mentioned the top five. Austin James, solid top 10 for him. Mitchell Collins, Chris Kyle, Tyler Mills, and Edwin Mendez. But Christian Russell is going to score his first ever
DC Solar National Division win.
Heck yeah, boys! Awesome job on pit road! Awesome driver! Good job with the Alpha Win pit strategy here. We got it!
A big, big win here for Christian Russell.
Nice work, guys. Wow!
Dominant effort.
This has got to feel really good for that driver and the team.
Hell yeah.
Now their main focus should be going on to try to win the next round as well. As on for the next round, we will be going to Watkins Glen. And so after today, only the four races left. Chicagoland will be the final race before the season four chase here, or playoffs, I guess you could say. But Christian Russell and Robin Hood Racing is going to be celebrating huge. As I believe this is their second win on the season. Cameron Hathaway won out of Texas. And it's going to be Christian Russell winning here today. But congratulations to Christian Russell on his first career National Division win. He is now the 12th driver in the playoffs. But like I said, he is not safe. Two or more wins will guarantee you in the playoffs. Next round, we head to Watkins Glen for both National and the Cup divisions. Until then, we'll see you for the Cup race here at Denver. Let's get you down to Victory Lane where Christian Russell celebrates.